गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन, वेलकम टू पुलिस हेड क्वार्टर्स। सो आज को जो ब्रिफिंग प्राइमेरली देर आर टू थिंग्स वी वांट टू यू नो एक तब भन्न चाहे हमारा में दुईटा केस रजिस्टर भारत एवं सदर पुलिस स्टेशन में हो। सदर पुलिस स्टेशन में 6 अगस्त 2020 मेरा केस रजिस्टर भाग ए फेरि गर्नुछ ल ओके माइक अफ छ यो त अफ छ त माइक कसरी यो अफ छ है माइक यो चल्दैन रहेछ त ओके ओके गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन आई थिंक नाउ आई एम अडिबल राइट। सो आज को कन्फ्रेन्स प्राइमेरली हामी तपाईहरुलाई दुईटा कुराको लागि बोलाएको थियो। हाम्रोमा अब अरेस्ट त भइबस्छ, केस पनि भइबस्छ हैन, तर यो चाहिँ इम्पोर्टेन्ट किन थियो भन्दाखेरि सो हाम्रोमा दुईटा केस रजिस्टर भएको थियो। एउटा चाहिँ सदर पुलिस स्टेशनमा 6 अगस्त 2020 मा भएको थियो है। यो चाहिँ तपाईको कम्प्लेनेन्ट हुनुहुन्थ्यो मिस्टर चितेन टासी भुटिया, अन्त यसमा चाहिँ अगेन्स्ट जुन चाहिँ सिमरन गुरुङ भन्ने एउटा फेसबुक प्रोफाइल थियो, अगेन्स्ट द्याट प्रोफाइल भएको थियो है। यसमा चाहिँ सेक्सन चाहिँ 153A 505 सब सेक्सन 1 एन्ड 2 506 र 120B भएको थियो है। सो बेसिकली के भन्नु प्रमोटिङ एनिमिटी बिट्विन टू डिफ्रेन्ट कम्युनिटिज भनेर होइन। सो एउटा यो केस हो। सेकेन्ड केस चाहिँ हाम्रो सदर के भन्छ सिआइडी पुलिस स्टेसनमा भएको थियो। यो चाहिँ आउटरेजिङ द मोडेस्टी अफ अ वुमन 354 आइटी एक्टमा 67A अन्तखेरि आइपिसी 509। यो दुईवटा केस भएको थियो। यो सेकेन्ड चाहिँ तपाईँको एउटा देविका छेत्री भन्ने प्रोफाइल थियो। सो त्यसमा चाहिँ केस रेजिस्टर भएको थियो। सो दिज टू वर कग्निजेबल अफेन्सेस राइट एन्ड क्वाइट सिरियस वन्स। सो फर दिस वी हेभ द आयो अफ द सदर पुलिस स्टेसन केस एसआई किशोर एन्ड फर सिआइडी वी हेभ एसआई अभिषेक दाहाल होइन। अन्त अन दि टेबल वी हेभ हाम्रो थिन्ले, हि इज द साइबर एक्सपर्ट म्याडम हुनुहुन्छ, पिआरओ म्याडम हुनुहुन्छ हिसे म्याडम, एन्ड वी हेभ एएसपी क्राइम ब्रान्च राइट। सो यो चाहिँ हामीहरूले हुन्छ नि यस्तरी वी एफेक्टेड एरेस्ट फर बोथ दिज केसेस वेन वी वर एबल टु आइडेन्टिफाई द पर्सन्स युजिङ दिज पर्टिकुलर प्रोफाइल्स राइट। सो यसमा वी हेभ एफेक्टेड एरेस्ट यस्तरी इभिनिङ, वी हेभ डन इन्टरग्रेसन फर अलमोस्ट नाउ ओभर 18 आवर्स, एन्ड वी हेभ गट पुलिस कस्टडी फर द नेक्स्ट 4 डेज टिल 6th of November वी हेभ गट कस्टडी फ्रम देम। Now, moving ahead, if you have questions, you can ask me questions. Subsequently, at the end, again, I'll speak more. Yeah. ROP, tabaiko, your first case ma chai, junche, Sadar Police Station ko case sa. Before that, I would like to place on record that it was a collaborative effort between the district police, East District, as well as CID. So only after proper collaboration, we could, you know, crack both these cases. इन द फर्स्ट केस सिमरन गुरुङको जुन चाहिँ छ केस चाहिँ त्यसमा चाहिँ देयर आर मोर देन वान अक्युज, देयर आर अबाउट 4 to 5 अक्युज राइट नाउ। वी हेभ बिन एबल टु न्याप वान अफ देम, हिज नेम इज मिस्टर राजेश राई, सन अफ विक्रम राई, एन्ड ही ह्यापन्स टु बी फ्रम 3rd mile जिएन रोड राइट। एन्ड इन द सेकेन्ड केस द्याट इज देविका गुरुङको जुन चाहिँ केस छ यसमा चाहिँ सर देविका छेत्री सरी यसमा चाहिँ तपाईँको अक्युज इज प्रकाश गुरुङ। वी हेभ आइडेन्टिफाइड हिम एज दि प्राइम अक्युज हु इज बिन युजिङ दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोफाइल। सो इन देविका छेत्री इज केस दिज ओन्ली वान पर्सन इज युजिङ इट, वेयर एज सिमरन गुरुङ इट्स अबाउट 4 to 5 पिपल, एन्ड वी आर स्टिल यु नो इट्स स्टिल अन्डर वट यु कल इन्भेस्टिगेसन विथ रिगार्ड टु एफेक्टिङ एरेस्ट अफ द रिमेनिङ अफ दि अक्युज। If you have questions, you can ask him.
Mr. Prakash Gurung is from Pakyong?
Yes, Pakyong.
I think we are talking about Mr. Prakash
Gurung. Yes, yes, yes.
So,
it is more of a technical, you know, analysis that we have done. सो जस्ट लाइक के भन्छ तपाईँको ट्रेडिसनल क्राइममा पनि जसरी हामीले हाउ वी लिङ्क द क्राइम विथ द क्रिमिनल त्यसरी नै जस्तो फिङ्गरप्रिन्ट भयो डिएनए फिङ्गरप्रिन्ट हुन्छ त्यसरी नै हाम्रो डिजिटल इन्भेस्टिगेसनमा पनि देयर आर फिङ्गरप्रिन्ट्स एन्ड फिङ्गरप्रिन्ट्स आर लाइक एब्सोल्युटली युनिक राइट सो द्याट इज हाउ वी हेभ आइडेन्टिफाइड बोथ अफ देम नट जस्ट बोथ अफ देम बट देयर आर लट मोर पिपल वी हेभ आइडेन्टिफाइड बट इन्भेस्टिगेसन इज स्टिल अन्डर प्रोसेस एन्ड वी आर स्टिल इफेक्टिङ एरेस्ट अफ लट अफ अदर एक्युज एज वेल यस वी हेभ टेकन अन्डर 27 एभिडेन्स एक्टमा उहाँले एउटा कन्फेसन भन्छ तर कन्फेसन इज नट एडमिसिबल बट वाट एभर लिड्स द फ्याक्ट लिडिङ आफ्टर द्याट कन्फेसन सो वी हेभ रिकभर्ड लट अफ डेटा फ्रम द प्रोफाइल अफ सिमरन गुरुङ सो वी हेभ अलरेडी सिज्ड इट इन प्रेजेन्स अफ विटनेसेस वी आर सेन्डिङ इट फर एनालिसिस वी हेभ केप्ट वान कपी फर आवर सेल्भ बिकज इट्स एन एक्टिभ इन्भेस्टिगेसन सो वी आर ट्राइङ टु इन्स्योर द्याट यु नो we have effected arrest only after being 110% sure that the person we have identified are the person behind these particular two profiles.
Sir, you mentioned that Mr. Rajesh Rai arrested.
Yes.
Mr. Prakash Guru?
Yes.
He's also arrested?
Yes, yes, he's also arrested.
When the arrest was effected, sir?
It was effected yesterday evening. Yes, see, there are a lot more people who are involved in this particular two cases, okay? Now, 120 B pan is hamro, yo Simran Gurungko case, it is basically ke bhanne, criminal conspiracy. So there are more than one people who are involved. So for instance, if a particular post was put up, which caused disharmony between two communities, it was done not just by one person, but someone else provided the content. So it was, you know, a mixture of more than four or five people. So we have identified some of them. We would not like to name them right now because, So Barap Namgyal, who is also involved in a previous case, last year, this February, he was arrested, right, on a case of forgery. So in this particular case also, we have enough evidence which leads to, show us that he was involved in providing a lot of content. So that is how, we wanted to not effect arrest, but we wanted to involve him in the investigation. But he has not cooperated so far. So that's how it is.
What's the punishment if proven?
Pardon?
What's the punishment if proven?
Punishment is, whatever the law says, as per the section, whatever relevant punishments are there, I cannot exactly, tell you because it is quite extensive, because we have a lot of sections. So. These are all cognizable offences, non-bailable offences. Because bailable offence, Mata, we cannot keep someone for more than, in the evening we have to let them go. Whereas in this case, both of them are cognizable and non-bailable offences.
So the sources informed us that the arrested people were taken Panthal for the interrogation. Why is it so?
No, it was an active investigation. So basically what we do is, see, if we want to question someone, we would want to question wherein there is no interference. So Pangthang is one place wherein, mobile phone signals do not reach that easily. So for the benefit of the entire team, we did not want any phone calls in between while the investigation was going on. So that is why we chose Pangthang, because it is a place which is conducive for, interrogation and everything.
Sir, basically, you are active only on two contents, that was registered as Sadar Thana and one at the CID Police. During investigation,
See, it is like this, okay? So till now we have, I think, across 27, 28 police stations across Sikkim, we have more than 50 complaints against various, Facebook profiles with regard to personal defamation. We have complaints from secretaries where saying ki complain matlab defame garyo. We have complaints from individuals ki wahako naam badnaam garyo, wahalai esto bhanyo, usto bhanyo bhanera. But we cannot work on subjective lines, Police has to be very, very objective. The moment a complaint comes, agar complaint ma tapaiko cognizable offense ha bhane, police can take cognizance, register a case, subsequently arrest someone. Non-cognizable cha bhane, we are not given the privilege by law to do something without the law, right? So law is black and white. Agar tesma non-cognizable offense ha bhane, we cannot register a case. However, yes, we conduct inquiries. So before these two profiles, you know, we have had more than 50 complaints. So we have a lot of other profiles. For instance, we have profiles like Roshan Wang Pradhan. We have profiles like Awas Awas. We have profiles like Kunsaru.
Puchtai Sikkim.
So we know the guys who are running all this. Okay, so we already have their phone numbers. We have already logged their IPs. But as a law-abiding police force, you know, as someone who is very, very technical, we cannot just go and do something, you know, on a non-cognizable complaint. Whereas these two complaints were absolutely cognizable. There was a case registered. That's why action was taken. Okay, I think a very important thing to understand is, you know, unse ni hamro police matlab law and order situation unse ni law and order situation hunda kheri there's always a lot of people in the crowd, right? So if there are more than 50 people, there is something called as dispersal of responsibility. You know, as an individual, you would not shout or destroy public property compared to when you are a part of a 50-person group. So त्यति बेला चाहिँ डिस्पोजल रेस्पोन्सिबिलिटी हुन्छ. सो त सबैले सोच्छ कि मैले गरेको चाहिँ त्यति बेसी होइन, तर एज अ ग्रुप दे डु अ लट अफ ड्यामेज. नाउ सिमिलर कन्टेक्स्टमा हेऱ्यो भने हाम्रो फेसबुकमा पनि जति पनि एनोनमस प्रोफाइल्सहरू छ, होइन, उहाँहरूले चाहिँ अब दे हेभ देयर ओन रिजन्स वाइ दे डु द्याट. आई मिन क्रिएट फेक प्रोफाइल्स, राइट? एन्ड देन यु नो वी हेभ कम्प्लेन्स वेयर इन अ लेडी कम्स टु अस एन्ड टेल्स कि सर हाम्रो बारेमा मेरो बारेमा यस्तो लेख्यो उस्तो लेख्यो. A government official comes and tells us ki sir hamro barema yesto lekhyo photo khiche yesto garyo usto garyo boliko din ma you guys press ko mai huncha ni ba yesto lekhcha. So all those complaints fall under the ambit of non cognizable offense, right? Whereas one find a list of things they are doing ma chai they will say something like what happened in this particular case. In this particular case the you know the complaint has yo sarkar nepali jyan kare मारा सरकार भयो, होइन, सी ब्ल्याकको इसारामा एमके शर्मा र विष्णु बडालाई धुलाई भयो. सो दिज आर थिङ्स विच क्रिएट यु नो टू डिफरेन्ट सेट अफ कम्युनिटिज एन्ड देन इट स्प्रेड्स फ्रिक्सन बिट्विन दिज टू कम्युनिटिज. नाउ जसले लेख्यो उसले सोच्यो होला जोसमा लेखिहाल्यो भनेर, होइन, बट दिस टर्न्ड आउट टु बी अ कग्निजेबल अफेन्स. सो वी ह्याड टु रेजिस्टर अ केस. सो सदर पुलिस स्टेसन रेजिस्टर्ड अ केस एन्ड सब्सिक्वेन्टली वी ह्याड टु आइडेन्टिफाई हु वाज बिहाइन्ड दिस पर्टिकुलर फेक आइडी. Now, moving ahead, we have already told you that we have more than 50 complaints. We have already identified, just to Awas Awas, Roshan Wang Pradhan, you said, Namchi Basne, Nani Aro, Unchani, 21, 22, hai na, Sensei Nani Aro, sir. Yo particular case ma apani, yo particular bhai 30 years ko mathe, aru ketara apani, 31, 32 ketara mathe, sir. So all of them are young guys, Unchani. And so from CID, what we want to is, you know, give a message is, your right to expression, freedom of expression is your right. Till now, I think not a single case has been there wherein tapaile kunai kasaile criticize garda, government la criticize garda kheri, ya ta kasaile ke bhanda kheri tapaiko against ma kunai cognizable case bhako chha bhanera, haina. But when you do a fake profile, then you have that anonymity ko huncha ni, maile gare bhane thaha paundaina, tyo chha nasochnus tapaiharule, because we already have identified, we have the wherewithal, Sikkim police has the wherewithal with regard to the technical capabilities to find out kole gardacha bhanera. So it is just a matter of time ki you might be just someone who is committing a non cognizable offense, but one fine day you write something and it becomes cognizable. Then again suddenly the whole criminal justice system comes into picture, right? Because once you are an accused, then we have to take you to JC, we have to take you to police custody, judicial custody. Tapaila pani aba huncha ni for a thing which you thought would never happen will happen to you. So with this, you know, our society, Sikkim society, if you remove social media, I wouldn't think anyone says anyone etti sa naramro kasale pani bhandaina kasale physical world mai. It is only because of social media ko anonymity huncha ni, people nowadays have become much more, I don't know, insensitive is the right word I guess, and then they say and do things on social media, you know, behind fake profiles wherein they believe they won't be caught. But I would like to tell that we already have identified people who have committed non cognizable offenses, but we have not taken action. Why? Because we are a very, very technical, you know, law abiding police force. And once again, I would like to tell everyone that agar tapaiharule fake chalaudai chha bhane it is not an offense. तपाईले फेक सोशल मिडिया या कुनै फेक फेसबुक प्रोफाइल इज नॉट एन ऑफेंस बट थ्रू दैट मीडियम तपाईले कुनै चीज गर्नुभयो भने इफ दैट बिकम्स यू नो अ कॉग्निजिबल ऑफेंस देन अगेन यू बिकम लाइक एनी अदर कॉमन क्रिमिनल सो दैट इज व्हाट आई वुड वांट टू से. Yes, in Simran Gurung we have about 4 to 5 people who are, you know, using the same profile because they have the access to it. Right now we've caught one of them because he seemed to be the most educated, you know, amongst all the guys. So we presume that if we catch him, you know, we would ensure that the evidence is not deleted. So today we've managed to gather all the evidence as well from his phone, you know, from the Facebook profile, through Evidence Act, 27 Evidence Act ma hamile waha ko confession liyo, presence of witnesses, he himself accessed the profile and gave us the content, and we downloaded the entire content, whatever he has done till now, from the beginning, that is July 1st, 2019, when the profile was created. So that is how it is.
So is it like, you know, the recently added infrastructure in crime division helped in this investigation? Because
yes, the cyber crime, you know, recently launched cyber crime lab has helped us a lot because there were things which previously we were short sometimes, you know, we had to refer to some CFSL or somewhere. But right now with the capabilities that have been brought about by this particular lab, it becomes much more easier for us to track, you know, any fake profile which may, you know, commit a cognizable offense. Yeah.
And would these people arrested are politically affiliated with the political party?
See, again, you know, that is something even the accused would want to believe. But for us, it is very, very simple, you know. I've already told you, we've identified other people who have been, you know, involved in other non-cognizable offenses. But we have not taken action. Simply, when a complaint comes, non-cognizable, we registered a GD entry, we do our own, you know, inquiry. But that inquiry does not lead to further action because we are not mandated by law to do such thing. Whereas in this case, we did not have the privilege of not acting. We got the information, we acted upon it, we analyzed it, and finally we, you know, zeroed in on these two people. I mean, not just these two, but more than these two. Yes, it's a still ongoing investigation. We have contacted West Bengal police. There are people in parts of Bengal as well. So yes. Yes.
Okay. In Bengal.
Yes, I mean, presently the location is in Bengal, but they have been in Sikkim as well. So, you know, some of them have, you know, mobile, customer application form, what is called, CAF. Basically, when you buy a SIM card, you have to give your ID, everything, right? So when we requisition such things from the service providers, some of them have addresses of Kalimpong, you know, some Darjeeling. So we are still identifying, but it's just a matter of time before we grab all of them. Devika Chhetri, I would like to, you know, I would not like to reveal it because again, it pertains to, you know, outraging the modesty of a woman. So I would like to protect her identity. Okay, with regard to the Sadar police station case, it is dated 6th of August 2020, case number 123/2020, and the sections are 153A/505, 506, and 120B of the Indian Penal Code. 120B. And no, this is against the handlers of Simran Gurung, because at that point of time the complaint was on the user of that, right? And the second case is CID PS case number 12, and the sections are 354 IPC, 509 IPC, and 67A of the IT Act.
7A.
E. 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 Devika Chhetri is 2nd of November 2020.
2nd November?
Yeah.
Both the cases have been registered in 2020?
Yeah, yeah. One is in Sadar Police Station, Simran Gurungko. The second one is...
2nd November 2020?
Ijo.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, no, we had the complaint earlier. Because CID Mache, the process is we cannot directly register a case. No? We have to seek approval of DGP. So, Yanirache, Sikkim Police Manual, CID Majunja Police Station, sir, it requires approval of DGP for registration of case. If you have any questions for the IO, we have Kishore, cyber expert is here, then we have Abhishek Dahal. If any questions, please ask. Once, thank you.